where she's going. Yeah,
I like that. And do they have the words to the Oh, What a Beautiful Morning?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just in time, I found you just in time. Before you came, my time was running low. I was lost, the losing dice were tossed. My bridges all were crossed.
Thank you. So great to see so many of you here. This morning's service, Find Your Way Through Music and Poetry, was created and organized by myself, Elliot, Wendy, and Dave Blom to serve as a midsummer inspiration. Many thanks to our other First Parish players, Catherine Calzada and George Gonacanto, for performing with us today. There are two more poems that are added to your service, and you'll come upon them. The Mindfulness by Mary Oliver and The Weaver and the Loom by Dana Falls. We won't be doing Stone's Joys and Concerns this morning, but our Pastoral Care Associate of the Week is Rick Vincent. And the beautiful flowers right here came from Wendy's garden.
When we take the time to slow down, we sometimes try to reassess what we're doing in our lives and where we're going. It's like we try to find our way again, reset our life journey to align with our values and our dreams for the future. It's a solitary, meditative process, but there are tools to help. We use music. It gives us a rhythm and an emotional frame. We feel connected to the music. It can validate our emotional state or give it a nudge in another direction. Poetry does the same when we find a poem that speaks to our deepest yearnings or just serves as a friend who validates our own experience. Poetry can be inspiring, moving us to be better, more engaged with the environment, more understanding of other points of view. This morning, we're going to offer samples of poems that can help guide us on our way through life, interspersed with music that can be a boost of joy, a reminiscence, and an entertainment.
We light our chalice with words from Florence Kaplow. We kindle this flame, honoring the doorways in our souls, the windows through which we gaze at one another, the balconies where we catch glimpses of sky, the thresholds we stand on, wondering, hoping, fearing, dreaming. Now, if we can say our covenant together. The Unitarian Universalist tradition, the covenant, is a set of promises the members of a congregation strives to honor with one another and out in the world. We strive to live up to these promises every day. Please say, along with me, the words of our parish covenant as found in your orders of service. We gather as a loving community to encourage and comfort one another. We gather as a serious community to support each other in our search for spiritual truth. We gather as a service community to live our beliefs through action and care for our world.
Our hymn today is the song, Oh, What a Beautiful Morning. It was the opening song from Oklahoma, the 1943 Rodgers and Hammerstein musical. You probably all know it very well. Please rise if you wish.
Now, you may have your lyrics maybe have something about Gordon McRae in there. Well, Gordon McRae is the cowboy in the movie Oklahoma who starts the movie. But it was Rodgers and Hammerstein who wrote the So I'm going to do a slight intro, and then we'll just start singing. I'm hoping you all know, I'll stand and sing. That's right. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is high as an elephant high, and it looks like it's climbing. Oh, what a beautiful morning. cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads when they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the sound of the earth are like music. All the sound
Okay, Groovin' Low by Alfred Bennett Spellman. Spellman, born in 1935, is an American poet and music critic who is considered part of the Black Arts Movement in the 1960s. This poem combines music and poetry explicitly. My swing is more mellow these days, not the hard bop drive I used to roll, but more of a cool foxtrot. My eyes still close when the rhythm locks. I've learned to boogie with my feet on the floor. I'm still moving, still grooving, still falling in love. I bop to the bass line now. The trap set, paradiddles, rattamacues, and flams that used to spin me in place still set me off, but I bop to the bass line now. I enter the tune from the bottom up and let the trumpet and sax wheel above me. So don't look for me in the treble. Don't look for me in the fly staccato splatter of the hot young horn. No, you'll find me in the nuance, hanging out in inflection and slur. I'm the one executing the half-bent dip in the slow, slow drag with the smug little smile and the really cool shades.
Yeah.
This poem is A Walk by Rainer Maria Rilke. He was an Austrian poet and novelist born in 1875. And I personally love this because it helps me visualize what I want to be doing in the future and reminds me to be welcoming of the opportunities that just always seem to pop up to help me get there. My eyes already touch the sunny hill, going far ahead of the road I have begun. So we are grasped by what we cannot grasp. It has an inner light, even from a distance, and changes us, even if we do not reach it, into something else, which, hardly sensing it, we already are. A gesture waves us on, answering our own wave, but what we feel is the wind in our faces.
This poem is Beginnings by Denise Levertov, who is said to be one of the greatest poets of the 20th century. This poem, I think, reflects her musicality and hope. It was written in the 1930s, but it still speaks to today. Hope and desire set free, even the weariest river winds somewhere to the sea. But we have only begun to love the earth. We have only begun to imagine the fullness of life. How could we tire of hope? So much is in bud. How can desire fail? We have only begun to imagine justice and mercy. Only begun to envision how it might be to live as siblings with beast and flower. Not as oppressors. Surely our river cannot already be hastening into the sea of non-being. Surely it can drag in the silt all that is innocent. Not yet. Not yet. There is too much broken that must be mended. Too much hurt we have done to each other that cannot yet be forgiven. We have only begun to know the power that is in us if we would join our solitudes in the communion of struggle. So much is unfolding that must complete its gesture. So much is in bud. Okay, we're going to do a responsive reading, number 490, in the back of your hymnals, Wild Geese by Mary Oliver. I will read the plain text, and if you can follow in with the italics. You do not have to be good. You only have to let the soft animal of your body love what it loves. Meanwhile, the world goes on. Ordinary Life by Barbara Crooker. Barbara Crooker is an American poet, born in 1945. She actually lives near where I grew up in eastern Pennsylvania. This poem reminds us to savor and be grateful for the comfort and love in our everyday lives. Nothing lasts forever.
This was a day when nothing happened. The children went off to school without a murmur, remembering their books, lunches, gloves. All morning, the baby and I built block stacks in the squares of light on the floor, and lunch blended into nap time. I cleaned out kitchen cupboards, one of those jobs that never gets done, then sat in a circle of sunlight and drank ginger tea, watched the birds at the feeder jostle over lunch's little scraps. A pheasant strutted from the hedgerow, preened and flashed his jeweled head. Now a chicken roasts in the pan, and the children return, the murmur of their stories dappling the air. I peel carrots and potatoes without paring my thumb. We listen together for your wheels on the drive, grace before bread. And at the table, actual conversation, no bickering or pokes. And then the drift into homework, the baby goes to his cars, drives them along the sofa's ridges and hills. Leaning by the counter, we steal a long, slow kiss, tasting of coffee and cream. The chickens diminish to skin and skeleton, the moon to a comma, a sliver of white. But this has been a day of grace in the dead of winter, the hard, cold knuckle of the year. A day that unwrapped itself like an unexpected gift. And the stars turn on, order themselves into the winter night.
This next poem was written by Tad Staley, a member of our congregation, very active here. He wasn't able to come and read it himself, but he told me his inspiration. He says, "This poem came to me one day on my daily walk in the woods at Wilson Mountain in Dedham. It was a reminder that as I entered the woods with the outer life of thoughts and plans buzzing in my head, my feet were where I came into contact with the actual world and were the means for guiding a walking meditation." His poem is called "Grounding." "Today, my feet did the praying. My head, seeking meaning, was divided. My heart, seeking love, unrequited. My gut, seeking justice, disquieted. But my feet found the ground solid, each footfall stable and reassuring. Trod the rough path of dirt and leaves and rocks that buttress my very being. Today, I follow my feet. They know where I'm going. They hear the voice of the earth, and it is holy. Today, I am blessed through my feet." Okay, this poem is not listed in your service, but it is "Mindfulness" by Mary Oliver. I know many of you know and love Mary Oliver. She's my favorite poet. She's an award-winning best-selling poet known for her poems of the natural world. "Mindfulness," I find, is spiritual and contemplative, calming and lovely. "Every day I see or hear something that more or less kills me with delight, that leaves me like a needle in the haystack of light. It was what I was born for, to look, to listen, to lose myself over and over in joy and acclamation. Nor am I talking about the exceptional, the fearful, the dreadful, the very extravagant, but the ordinary, the common, the very drab, the daily presentations. Oh, good scholar, I say to myself, how can I help but grow wise?" This summer in July and August, our plate collection is shared equally between First Parish and Needham Community Council. To give to today's plate collection, text the message UU Needham plate and the amount. To phone number 73256. To give towards your pledge, put the 2-digit year 23 or 24 with the word pledge in the text. UU Needham pledge and the amount. 273526. Or checks can be made out to First Parish in Needham, memo line collection, and mailed to 23 Dedham Ave, Needham, Mass. May the usher come forward.
So the inclusion of this song by Lyle Lovett may seem a little different since it's not classical jazz, but Wendy and I had the wonderful experience to see Lyle Lovett in Lowell on Thursday night, and he was with his 14-piece band, what they call the big band, and boy, do they play jazz. So it's an unusual song, as most of his songs are. But and if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. If I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. We would all together go out on the ocean. I said, me upon my pony, on my boat. And if I wore Roy Rogers, I'd sure enough be single. I wouldn't bring myself to marry an old Dale. Well, it'd just be me and Trigger. Through the movies, then we'd buy a boat, and on the sea we'd sail. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride in my boat, and we would all together go out on the ocean. I'd take me upon Mystery Masked Man was smart. He got himself a Tonto, cause Tonto did the dirty work for free. But Tonto, he was smarter, and one day said Kemosabe, well, kiss my ass, I bought a boat, I'm going out to sea. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I
we'll read responsively. This is a Yom Kippur prayer. Again, I'll read the plain text. and you can read the text in italics. Birth is a beginning and death a destination. From childhood to maturity and youth to age. From weakness to strength, or strength to weakness and back again. From health to sickness and back, we pray to health again. And together, from defeat to defeat, until looking backward or ahead, we see that victory lies not at some high place along the way, but in having made the journey stage by stage. I'd like to invite Nancy Temple to come up and read her poem.
Oh, look, it's printed out for me. I think mine is a little bigger. This poem is called Under Ideal Conditions by Al, I'm afraid I don't know how to pronounce his name, Zolynas, Zolynas. He's Austrian, born in 1945 of Lithuanian parents, lives in California, and this poem was written in 1994. Say in the flattest part of North Dakota, on a starless, moonless night, no breath of wind, a man could light a candle, then walk away. Every now and then he could turn and see the candle burning. 17 miles later, provided conditions remained ideal, he could still see the flame. Somewhere between the 17th and 18th mile, he would lose the light. If he were walking backward, he would know the exact moment when he lost the flame. He could step forward and find it again, back and forth, dark to light, light to dark. What's the place where the light disappears, where the light reappears? Don't tell me about photons and eyeballs, reflection and refraction. Don't tell me about 186,000 miles per second and the theory of relativity. All I know is that place where the light appears and disappears, that's the place where we live. The end.
Okay, and now I'd like to invite Leslie Ross-Deignan up for her poem.
Thanks, Lynn. From falling in love is like owning a dog. An epithalami, okay, here, I knew I wouldn't be able to do this right. An epithalamian, now you're probably wondering what that is. I know I was wondering what it was. It's a form of an ode that was popular in the 16th century, and it was often recited at marriages. Edmund Spenser was famous for one that he wrote for his daughter at her marriage, at her wedding. And the poet, Taylor Molly, who's a 20th century poet, and a slam and a spoken word poet, who wrote this poem, this epithalamian, had a lot of fun with this form of poetry. He's a modern poetry, obviously. So instead of being in praise of a marriage, a traditional marriage, this poem is in praise of the age-old relationship between people and dogs. First of all, it's a big responsibility, especially in a city like New York. So think long and hard before deciding on love. On the other hand, love gives you a sense of security. When you're walking down the street late at night and you have a leash on love, ain't no one gonna mess with you. Love doesn't like being left alone for long, but come home and love is always happy to see you. It may break a few things accidentally in its passion for life, but you can never be mad at love for long. Is love good all the time? No. No. Love can be bad. Bad love. Bad. Very bad love. Sometimes love just wants to go for a nice long walk. It runs you around the block and leaves you panting. It pulls you in different directions at once, or winds around and around you until you're all wound up and can't move. But love makes you meet people wherever you go, people who have nothing in common but love. They stop and talk to each other on the street. Throw things away, and love will bring them back again and again and again. But most of all, love needs love, lots of it. And in return, love loves you and never stops.
Okay, this poem isn't listed in your order of service either. It's called The Weaver and the Loom by Dana Falls. She's a longtime yoga practitioner and American poet whose gentle words encourage us to celebrate the wonder of being here and to experience the connection of breath. There was a point in my life when I was a weaver on a 62-inch loom that took up over half my living room. And this poem reminded me of setting up the warp and the weft, then shooting the threads through with a shuttle to create a pattern. Every thread was woven into a tapestry of my life. Sit here for a bit. Place yourself outside the frenzied pace of life. Slow down long enough to appreciate birds in flight, water drops like prisms in the grass and countless shades of green. Step off the fast track and listen to the sound of breath and birdsong. Take a moment just to be, and in the being, know the whole of this creation, mystery and madness, passion and profanity. Know it all is one stunning tapestry. Sit still, and the thin line between sacred and profane simply fades away. There is nothing then to reconcile. All the disparate threads are woven on the loom of life. Sit here for a bit, and your unique place in the pattern becomes clear. Take the still point with you when it's time to walk away. Make the choice to see affinity, to watch the picture taking shape as thread joins thread. Dare to be the weaver and the loom, creator and creation, the sower and the sown. In a moment of stillness, all that came before is seen as one.
As we extinguish our chalice today, I'll say these words by Thich Nhat Hanh. He was a Vietnamese Tiền Buddhist monk, peace activist, prolific author, poet, and teacher. He was born in 1926 and passed away only last year. The most precious gift we can offer others is our presence. May we learn to listen, to respond, to feel, to grow, to touch the life that is in everyone, to love.
I put together some music notes that came with your program. I hope you can look them over. They tell you a little bit about some, you can only put a little bit in, but about some of the songs and the people who wrote them. The guy who wrote this is an unusual person, maybe the original hippie, but Nat King Cole had a big hit with it in 1948.
One, two.
Oops, I turned off in just a second. Something wrong with my... Let's start again. Go ahead, try it again.
One, two.
Wandered very far, o'er land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise was he. And then one day, a magic day, he passed my way. And while we spoke of many things, fools and kings, this he said to me, the greatest thing.